Hippocrates seminar. We did even have to stop the registration to the waiting list. I think it really means that the Hippocrates format is a great educational tool. So let me welcome you on behalf of the local organizing committee, Paola Del Sordo, Giusy Bonfante, and me. My name is Emanuele Mastretta. We feel responsible for the atmosphere of work here, so please feel free to ask about that to us. I will welcome you on behalf of our units. We are Terapia Intensiva Neonatale Ospedaliera of the Sant'Anna Hospital, and on behalf of the foundation, there's a foundation so supporting the work of our unit too. Just 5 minutes, no more, of your time to tell you why we did organize an Hippocrates and which is the idea that stays behind this program. I used to be in the Hippocrates audience, like you are, for so many times. And Hippocrates gave me the chance to meet people like Nick Kahneman. Was it Madrid 2007? Was it? And now Nick is our NEEDCAP tutor. We have been working for the last 2-3 years on the way of the NEEDCAP certification. And Hippocrates gave me the chance to meet Professor De Vries. Was in Lecco 2008, and then Rome, and then so many of the seminars she used to organize about brain monitoring. And for me to organize this seminar is a way to give back to Hippocrates what I earned from them. Because all the basis for our hypothermia program comes from this kind of work. And so it's a way to see old friends and to have new ones. We are still looking for people willing to share their knowledge, their experience, their expertise. And I think really this comes from Hippocrates, as Professor Cilio will tell us in a few minutes. The idea that stays behind the program is to link the three branches of the neonatal neurology, which is neuroprotection, and we will speak about hypothermia, about pharmacological neuroprotection, about seizure detection and treatment. To link it with neuro imaging, with EEG, with NIRS, with amplitude integrated EEG. So neuroprotection, neuromonitoring, and neuronurturing. We know how important it is. They can only grow up together because you cannot really take care and protect the brain of the newborn, the developing brain, without carefully monitoring it and without having deep in your mind, and I would say in your heart and even in your stomach, that also in the environment, sometimes painful, always overwhelming of our NICUs, there has to be a chance for our newborn of a safe relationship, as Nick will tell us, an opportunity of good relation, of course, if the parents are inside and if the medical staff is aware about it. Looking for connection is a difficult, is a challenging, would Nick say, challenging way of thinking. And for such a challenging target, such an excellent faculty. And before to leave you with Professor Cilio telling us something about the Hippocrates philosophy and introducing each one of you, I would like to thank you for your everyday work and for being here today for us. Thank you.
Thank you, Andrea, and thank you, all of you, for being here. So just a few words on Hippocrates. The main goal of Hippocrates is teaching. Teaching research and teaching excellent students. So we will do teaching and you will be the excellent student. So it means that you need to ask questions and we would like you to interact. And as the founder of Hippocrates, George Simbruner says, please ask all the questions you wouldn't dare to ask. Hippocrates wants to provide excellent biomedical education to young researchers and scientists all over the world. And the philosophy is exactly what you are seeing today. So small group of teachers, supposedly, I mean, excellent teachers, and really interaction, not only during the lecture, but even afterwards. And if you want to talk to us about your career, about what you want to do, how we can, I mean, we would like to help you in any way to foster your career. So Hippocrates was born in 1980 and has been growing very much. As you can see, most seminars are for postgraduate students. There are some basic research seminars. We try to integrate basic research with clinical work because we think it's important. And there are some seminars started a few years ago for nursing. It's all over the world. Recently, George Simbruner started with tele-education, so in some seminars, the lecture will be video recorded, so you can see the lecture later on, and I think this is also very useful. You need a password, of course, everything is protected. Okay, so Hippocrates seminar have been held all over the world. You see all the blue countries are countries where Hippocrates seminar have been held. And I think this has been quite successful. As Andrea was saying, most in every seminar there are a lot of students that are out because there are no sufficient place for everybody. So I think it's a very good formula. At the end, you will have to evaluate us, and I think this is also very important, and we are, you know, really try to do our best possible. You will have to do our evaluation at the last day. And this is very important to George Simbruner, to the organizer, because this is how lecturer will be selected. And this is George Simbruner, and this is me in Jakarta, and this is just to start this seminar, and thank you very much. And just to introduce you our speaker. So we have Linda De Vries. She doesn't need introduction. Linda is a professor of neonatal neurology. She's the head of the NICU in Utrecht in the Netherlands. She will present you on neuromonitoring, amplitude integrated EEG and imaging. She actually is the queen of imaging in newborns. Then we'll have Jérôme Jäger. He's a professor of pediatrics, University of Alberta in Edmonton in Canada. She did a lot of research of neuroprotection, and he will present us on pharmacology and neuroprotection and hypothermia. Nick Koeman, he's also from the Netherlands, from Rotterdam, and he's a trainer of NIDCAP trainer, he's another neonatologist, so you have two neonatologists, it's Linda and Nick, and two pediatric neurologists, Jérôme and myself, and Nick will present you on neuronurturing, as Andrea was telling you, and neurodevelopmental and the NIDCAP. And then myself, I'm a child neurologist and a neurophysiologist. I'm actually an epileptologist. I work at the University of California, San Francisco, when I recently moved from the Bambino Gesù Children's Hospital of Rome. This morning, we will start with some basic research. The intention is to give you tools to understand the clinical work, to understand how we choose new treatment, to understand why we approach disorders in the newborn period this way. So it's basic research as a tool.